Hi YouTube, this is Nuna. Welcome back for another video. I am just here to show you, share with you very quickly what I do for my daughter as a body moisturizer. So this right here in this double boiling pan, saucepan, see the fire is on medium. I am having here some raw shea butter. It looks like that. This is my shea butter. Okay. And my father bought that to me when he was like in a trip in Africa. I don't remember. I think it was in, I don't remember, Mali, Senegal, maybe one of both. And he bought me this. Okay, so I have been pouring about four teaspoons of raw shea butter, and now I'm about to add some almond oil. The brand is KTC, as you can see it. Okay, so I don't really measure what I'm doing. I usually, you know, go with the feeling, but let's say that for this one I might be going ahead and adding about maybe, I don't know, okay, this much of sweet almond oil. And now you can see it is melting. Okay, so what I'm going to do right now is let it melt very good. The shea butter takes a little bit of time to melt compared to the coconut oil, and I will be back in a few minutes to show you when it is completely, you know, melted. I'm turning off the fire right now, okay, and I will leave it like that for about, I don't know, 3 to 4 to 5 minutes, and I will be back. Stay tuned. Okay, welcome back. So it has cooled off, okay, and those little pieces that you see in the end are still some shea butter. Okay, so right now what I'm going to do is place this bowl in the freezer for about 10 to 15 minutes. You don't want to freeze it up. You just want it to be, you know, like solidify a little bit. You can put it in your refrigerator, but it will stay like longer, so I don't do it. I put it in the freezer, and then I will wait for about, yeah, 20 minutes seems a lot for myself because my freezer is crazy. So 10 to 15 minutes is good, and then I will come back, show you the result, and show you what I do next. Bye. Okay, so welcome back. This is the whipped shea, well, this is the almond oil and shea butter, and I left it freeze because I was studying, you know, doing my homework, and I completely forgot about it. Like maybe 20 minutes instead of the 15, well, 10 to 15. And yeah, so now I'm just taking this hand blender, and I'm about to start and mix it, okay? And it still is soft inside. And let me try to turn the light on without having the camera fall. Okay, so it looks like that, and you can see how soft it is still inside. Okay, and I will just, you know, mix it, shake it and mix it. And you really want it to be back to soft, you know. Too long. But anyways, it will cool off. And what I use to store my daughter stuff in is those, let me show you, those empty pots. You can get, well, I buy the mines here in France, but I think you can look on the internet or anywhere, and empty pots like that. And you really want to do all of this with clean hands, you know, like clean it. This was the one I used like about 2 months ago. I filled it up, and I use it on her body one time a day, and it's already empty. So now I cleaned it up with very hot, warm water, like, no, no, not warm, hot boiling water and soap, and my hands are clean. Like, especially for our kids, you want to double the care you give, you know, to the products, mixing and stuff like that. So right now what you want to do is wait for this to be a little bit softer, okay, and just put it into your pot, and you have got a homemade moisturizer. I don't keep this in the fridge, not at all. I just keep it in the bathroom here, and I moisturize her day one time a day with that. The reason why I am doing this is because my daughter, she's having an extra dry skin, and she was having eczema, you know, and she was like, especially inside her legs here, she was like at night time scratching so much, like she was ending up being extremely red, and she was developing some, how do you say that, the plaque, I don't remember the name. But since I did that, 2 months, people, 2 months, no more eczema on my daughter's body. So I thought I would just share, you know, like if ever one of you mothers is going through this same problem, just share it. So it comes like this, okay. If I grab just a little bit, it is like this. And when you put it on your hand, just look at that, okay? I know, melting, just like butter. It's just so soft, moisturizing. I just love it. Like on her body, it's just great. And it smells like shea butter. Now, I personally don't add any conservatives like vitamin E or any fragrance, vanilla extract or I don't know, you know, eucalyptus, stuff like that, because I know that her body is very fragile, so I keep it to the maximum as simple as I can. Shea butter, sweet almond oil, dot. This is it for her. So yeah, I hope this video was helpful. I will show you the pictures when I'm done, you know, like letting it be soft again. And please comment down here to let me know what you think. If you have got some recipes you want to share with me, this would be greatly appreciated. So, you know, kids, it is very important to take care of our kids' skin, hair, body, you know, educate them. I was not like educated like that because at that time it was not, you know, the habit. Well, in my area, I'm not talking for anybody else's, okay? But yeah, I want to do things differently for my daughter. So I definitely hope this was helpful for anybody. Thanks for watching. I'm in a rush because I have got some homework to do. Yes, I know. Mwah. Peace.